Hello students, welcome to our class and start our learning with Let's Learn. And our today's topic, resistors in series from chapter number 3, current electricity. So let's move on to today's topic. Students, in the previous lecture, we learnt about the electric circuit, different components connected to the circuit, that is a voltmeter, ammeter, then resistance, etc. In this lecture, we will see if the number of resistors are connected in a series, the number of resistors connected in a series. Then in a previous lecture, we studied about the Ohm's law. So just revise, what is the Ohm's law? So student, if I current flow from the circuit, the current flow from the circuit is I, then the potential difference between the two points, between the two ends of the conductor is V, then we know the current flow is directly proportional to the potential difference. Current flow is directly proportional to the potential difference. Okay, and we got this formula V equals to Ri. So this is a Ohm's law. So just in this lecture we will study if the number of resistors, let's consider three resistors here, R1, R2, R3, three resistors connected in a series, then what happened? The current flow, what is the value of the current flow will be there in this type of the circuit. It's clear. So students, when let's consider here three resistors R1, R2 and R3. Just observe in this picture on the board, R1, R2 and R3 are the resistors connected in a series. In a series means in a first resistor, the first end of the first resistor and the last end of the last resistor. For example, here three resistors. So first end of the resistor first and last end of the resistor 3 are connected to the battery. If we connect the number of resistors, then first end of the first resistor and last end of the nth resistor connected to the cell. So this arrangement is called the resistor in series. Okay, so just understanding, let's consider here three resistors R1, R2 and R3 are connected in series, and so the current flow, consider the current flow is I flow in this circuit, because the arrangement is in a series, so same current flow through these resistors, current I will flow through the resistor R2 and R will flow through this R3. Clear? Then let's consider the potential difference between the C. Let's consider these two ends, C and D. So the potential difference will be V1, V2 and V3. So consider V1 is a potential difference across the R1. Then V2 across the R2. Then V3 across the R3. Because here V1, V2 and V3, that means the potential difference will different, but current flow in this circuit is same. Understand? Through across these resistors, current flow is same, and that is equals to I. Clear, student? So throughout the circuit, consider here the potential difference is V. Just consider throughout this circuit, the average potential difference is V. Then we can write here V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Understand? And this is equation 1. It's clear, student? If the resistors, number of resistors connected in a series, then the current flow through these resistors is same, but the potential difference will different. So consider V1, V2 and V3 are the potential difference across the resistors R1, R2 and R3. So we can write V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3 if V is a effective resistance throughout the circuit. It's clear? Then let consider RS is the effective resistance. Here R1, R2 and R3 resistance in this circuit diagram, and they are connected in series. But effective resistance is R, let's consider. Then we know by the Ohm's law, we have V equals to IR. V equals to I into R. This is the formula from Ohm's law. V equals to IR. So, just put all the values. So, effective or potential difference. So, we can write V equals to IR because I is the same throughout the circuit. So V equals to IR. Then V1 is the potential difference across the R1. So V1 equals to IR1. I is the same. Okay. V2 equals to IR2 because V2 is the potential difference across the R2. V3 equals to IR3. Okay. So we have this values V, V1, V2 and V3. Put all the values of V, V1, V2 and V3 in the equation number 1. What is the equation number 1? V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So, put the values. So, we got IRS, RS for resistors, effective resistor connected in a series. So, IR is equals to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. It's clear. IR1, IR2 and IR3 are the values of V1, V2 and V3. We have the formula V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So put V1, V2 and V3, values of V1, V2, V3 in this equation. So IRS equals to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. So, cut all the I because I is same throughout the circuit. And we have RS equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Clear, student? So, if the resistors, the number of resistors connected in a series, then the effective resistance will be equal to the sum of the all resistors connected in the series. Understand? So RS equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus RN. If 5 resistors connected in the series, then RS equals to or effective R. Effective resistance equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 plus R5. It's clear? Then, some important instructions about the resistors connected in series. If we have this formula RS equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus and so on RN. So, student, if the resistors are connected in series, the same current flow through each resistor. Just remember, if these resistors connected in a series, then same current flow throughout the circuit. Number 2, the effective resistance of the resistors is equals to the sum of their individual resistance. That means RS equals to sum of all resistors R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus and so on. The potential difference between the two extreme of the arrangement is equals to the sum of the potential difference across the individual resistor. That means V equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. That means the sum of all potential difference is equals to the effective potential difference. It's clear? Then the effective resistance is larger than each resistance because the effective resistance is larger because the effective resistance is the sum of all potential difference. That's why the effective potential difference and effective resistance is larger than individual resistance and individual potential difference. It's clear, student? And then this arrangement is used to increase the resistance in circuit because we found the effective resistance is greater than the all individual resistance because we have this formula Rs equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So that's why the effective resistance is increased. Effective resistance is greater than all individual resistance. So that's why in this arrangement the resistance increase. If resistance increase, then current flow will control. Understand? Current flow will decrease because resistance increases. Understand? So the next student, when resistors are connected in series, then what is the disadvantage in this system? So if they are connected one after another, if any one of them doesn't function like this in the picture, if one of number of bulbs, let's consider number of bulbs are connected in this system, then if one bulb will fail, then the function of all circuit will fail because of the they are connected in series. Okay, so any one of them doesn't function, the circuit breaks and there will no flow of electricity, there will no flow of electricity. Understand? If two bulbs connected in the series and if one if two bulbs are connected in the series and they will both give less light than if they had been connected individually. Understand? Because in this case the resistance increase. If resistance increase, then the current flow decrease, and current flow decrease, so the both that are connected in the series, they blow the less light rather than if they connected individually. Okay, so this was today's lecture, student. If you have any query, you can message me. So let's see one numerical problems based on this system, this arrangement. So example is, if three resistors having a resistance 15 ohm, 3 ohm and 4 ohm are connected in series, then what is the effective resistance in the circuit? And we have the formula. What? The effective resistance is R1 plus R2 plus R3. Sorry, R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then put the values of R1, R2 and R3 in this equation. Then 15 plus 3 plus 4, that is a 22 ohm. So in this type you can solve all the problems based on this arrangement. I hope you understood today's lecture, student. If you have any doubt, you can message me. Please join the Google Classroom using this code and get homework notes and solutions. Thank you very much.